Hello, 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 and welcome to this another edition of Stampede Wrestling. And to illustrate the quality of the show, may I begin proceedings poetically. I have searched the whole world over, and there's no one who can ravage the English language half to death like a guy named Duke the Savage. Do you like that?
It's yours.
All of which serves to introduce the fact that the guy with a scintillating syntax, Duke Savage, is back from Boston, Massachusetts, tipping the old Toledo's a 2-5-0, and he's in there against Bruce Hart, the 215-pounder from Calgary, 35-pound weight disadvantage for Bruce. But I would suggest to you, as we near the 10-minute mark, that the fight thus far has been dominated by Hart. The third man in the ring, Sandy Scott.
Go, Duke, go! Go!
Don Gagne also back in the territory. There's Savage for a ride. There's a cover, and it's a one. That's all. Well, about two, maybe. The gent who had been expected and who is not here is the stopper. We've had word out of Nashville, Tennessee, that he is in hospital under doctor's care and probably cannot leave for better than a month. No further detail. Stopper is not here. No question, that's a disappointment. Still, there's the 10-minute mark, and still, we've got quite a card. Incidentally, this is the third bout on tonight's card, so you can see we certainly do not get all of the action. So if you have a chance to see the stars of Stampede Wrestling in person, get on out and do so. I think you'll enjoy it. I'll amend that statement. I know you'll enjoy it. Okay, that's Bruce Hart up top and Duke Savage down on the deck, trying to stay alive against the kid from Calgary. Have not seen Savage in 4 or 5 years. And if I'm not mistaken, the last time he was here, he left with a broken jaw as the result of an altercation with Stu Hart. One. That's all. Oh, man, he power dropped him. Two count. Bruce has got him on the edge, hasn't he? Oh, the big backbreaker. I say back, but it was a little lower, wasn't it? Just one. Poor old Duke. Getting a rude reception, is he not? Bruce Hart of Calgary. Young kid who's got quite a future. Duke Savage, the cagey veteran from Boston, Massachusetts. Mia. Hart fell on his shoulder. Well, it's time for the Savage. by the looks of things, as he starts to come on now, and really essentially for the first time in the fight. Savage with a big slam. Going after that soldier, too. Cover, one. Just one and a half. Well, Savage drives Bruce out. And looks very proud of himself in the proceedings. He drove him into that post. They're going to wipe it out. They're going to wipe it out. They are going to disqualify Duke Savage. And your winner will be Bruce Hart. Savage being disqualified for running hard into the steel post outside the ring. Duke Savage, the linguistic world breathlessly awaits your opening pronouncement.
Ed, that was an exemplary indication of how a good wrestler, utilizing sportsmanship in the highest integrities and qualities of wrestling, can emerge victorious, as I did now. I'm here for one personal reason. I love wrestling. I can go anywhere in the world and make a good living. But I left here with a broken jaw, sustained by the most despicable attack in the annals of wrestling history. Right here in this ring, there I was, winning, overpowering my opponent, going inexorably to victory, when Stu Hart stealthily attacked in the most despicable attack in wrestling history. Hit me in the jaw when I wasn't looking, fractured it in three places, incapacitated me for a number of months, where I had to undergo therapeutic training. I couldn't even talk for many months. Unable to communicate. My genius lied dormant while my fans and those that adore me asked, "Say something, Duke." I couldn't. My jaw is wired in 15 places. I'm sucking soup through a straw. All because of that underhanded, sneaky, disreputable attack by Stu Hart. Now I am in here on a personal vendetta. His strategy, as I've already found out, is thrust at me, all of his stooges, his puppets that he manipulates, hoping to stop me, to thwart my progress towards a match with Stu Hart. But who can do it? I just eliminated one of the masses, let him throw his big names, his sons, anyone that has the nerve and the capacity to step into this ring and endure my devastating attacks. I welcome them, because I want to prove once and for all, I want to go out of here with Stu Hart in a position that I was so he can emulate me. Let him suck soup for a straw. And when I leave here, there are going to be a lot of bleeding hearts.
I kind of wish I'd seen him when he was speechless. Well, here he is. The man from Quebec, Don Gagne, longtime North American heavyweight champion, against the Shocker from Shadyac, New Brunswick. Hubert Gallant, he's a dandy. Gallant in this match is outweighed by some 25 pounds, but he's got that speed, he's got that skill. Referee is Wayne Hart. Well, Duke Savage hasn't changed, has he? Still uses 1,000 words where one will do, you know. But Gagne, there's no question about his sincerity being in this territory, because he is back after that North American belt that's currently held by Jake Roberts.
Come on, Gagne, you can
But you see the speed and agility of young Mr. Gallant. Hammer locked by Gagne. But now Gagne had it reversed on him and steps out. Forgot to tell you, this is one fall with a 45-minute time limit. And we're in the early going. A little hard on the shoulder bone, I would suggest to you. Don Gagne is always yelling about being from the Republic of Quebec, but he is, in fact, from the province of Quebec, a part of Canada. Correct. You can see that Gallant not only has the speed and agility, he's got some power too, hasn't he? Can he pull him over? Almost went down, but he's hanging on. It was the hair. Here's the hair. And kiddies, I hate to tell you that he told the referee a fib. Yes, he did. Said he didn't do it. Tsk, tsk. Oh, my goodness. So you see, kiddies, if you continue to tell lies, you're going to grow up to be like Don Gagne. My heavens, what a fate. Gagne was fighting as a tag team partner with the late Michelle Martel in Puerto Rico several months ago when Martel was killed in a bout there. Terrible tragedy. And it still bothers Gagne to talk about it. Bothers us too, I'll tell you. Martel wound up getting a drop kick in the chest. It broke a rib and pierced the heart. Boom. Lights out for a guy who was only 33 years young. Well, Gallant is through. Oh, he's explosive, isn't he? Love him. Incidentally, perhaps I could point out to fans in this particular area that the stars of Stampede Wrestling are in action every Wednesday night in Saskatoon, every Thursday in Regina, every Saturday in Edmonton, and every other Tuesday up in Red Deer. And you people are watching in the Montana area, be sure to watch the newspapers that will be announcing special matches. That's in the Montana area. Okay. Don Gagne, Hubert Gallant in a one-fall struggle. And thus far, Gallant has been doing the pitching, Gagne the catching. Gagne trying to work his way up. Whoa! No cigar. Good move. Quick. Oh, beautiful arm drag, and he's up top again. Oh! And Gallant is greased lightning. We hope a little later in the show to view a few highlights of a bout between Hito and Sakurada against Keith and Bret Hart. Very important tag team struggle. Terry Sawyer against the Dynamite Kid, a major junior heavyweight battle. And Jake Roberts against Big Daddy Ritter, a big, big heavyweight struggle. Remind people in the Calgary area that Stampede is a couple of weeks away, and that some of the people who will be in action there include the world champion Harley Race, the world junior heavyweight champion Nelson Royle, Andre the Giant, the international tag team champions Dory Funk Jr. and Larry Lane, and the list goes on and on and on. We'll have a fantastic couple of weeks here at the Stampede. Mr. Gagne looks like he's not really enjoying the proceedings at this point in time. Trying to protect that left arm of his. It has been the victim of an arm drag or 10. Gagne has been working in the rings of New Zealand and Japan of late. But he doesn't want to be in this ring. Not at the moment. I must tell you that Hubert Gallant and Don Gagne went to the 30-minute time limit, and it was a draw. It went right to time, a draw, and quite a battle. Speaking of battles, ouch. Ouch, ouch, ouch. Sakurada down on his noggin, It's the combination of Hedo and Sakurada against Keith and Bret Hart. Very important tag team elimination bout. The winner to go against Larry Lane and Dory Funk Jr., the tag team champions. That's Hedo against Bret Hart with a backbreaker right there, Bret on the deck. We have passed the 15-minute mark. Very solid struggle. Hedo and Sakurada, there's no questioning their strength. They are considered to be the number one challengers for the title. Keith and Bret Hart are ranked number two challengers. But they're very closely matched. One, that's all. As we pick up the action, I will tell you that the ebb and flow of this match has, well, it's switched from one to the other, but right now, Bret Hart really clobbered on that turnbuckle. Right now, the Oriental duo dominating the proceedings. That's Sakurada against Bret Hart. One, two, two and a half, I call that one. Bret in a little trouble, could certainly use a tag. Keith and Bret Hart against Mr. Hedo, Mr. Sakurada. One fall, 45 minutes, near the 20-minute mark. Hedo in control right now. Bret trying to shake the cobwebs. Backbreaker, and he holds him there to pour on the pressure. Out of it. Yes, he did. Look at him go. There's the tag in it, Sakurada. Look out, Nelly. Oh, that backbreaker. Oh, man. He is rugged, is Mr. Sakurada. That's two. Oh, is he gonna pile drive him? Now he pulls him over the top and slams him. One, just one. We're at the 20-minute mark. One fall, 45-minute time limit. Bret and Keith Hart against Hedo and Sakurada. A tag team struggle. Oh, a beautiful uppercut. Bret could certainly use the tag. He makes it. Here's Keith. Keith Hart against Hedo. tag. Sakurada comes in, runs into a right-hand shot, mauls his man on the ropes. He's choking. Here's Hito. Up those ropes, over the top. Whoa, he's hanging on to him. He's going to airplane spin him. Pull him down. One, not quite. Ooh, Keith almost had him. One, two. One. Good knee. Right hand. Hito shakes it off. Pulls him over the top. One. Two. I don't know. He's counting here. Three. Four. He was counting them both. Pulls him over. One, two, three. He got him. He got him. He got him. He got him. Yes, he did. Sakurada maintaining there was a fast count there, but I don't think so. The Hart boys have scored a very narrow win. Hito does not believe the count. But the decision goes to the Harts. Well, Stu Hart, there's no question that that was a fine tag match.
That was one of the most grueling matches I've seen in many a time, many a day. That was a very hard-fought match. Both teams were giving it everything they had, and the Japanese boys have requested a return match since it's such an important occasion. I think they may be entitled to it. I don't want to be impartial since my boys were competing against them, so I'm going to grant them a
return. You're going to grant them a
match.
Return? Okay, behind me I have the specter of Bruce Hart in a sling. What happened?
I don't know. Savage kind of got a cheap shot on me and threw me into the ring post, and I think I might have separated the shoulder or dislocated. I'm just going to...
Looks like things are coming back to haunt me. Like, I unfortunately broke his jaw the last time I hit him, and that was about 2-3 years ago, and I don't know whether he's trying to get even on me or not, but I'm very disappointed to see this, and it's on his old shoulder separation that he had done
the
several
operation.
Years ago.
Yeah,
so I'm just hoping it'll be all right.
Okay.
I think I'll be back pretty soon. I hope it doesn't keep me out of the junior heavyweight title picture, but I owe Savage one, and if I can't get a shot at him, I'm sure my dad or one of my brothers will finish him off for me.
Okay, Bruce and Stu Hart and company. Oh, I'll tell you, here's a match and a half. The Dynamite Kid out of Liverpool, England, Terry Sawyer of Norfolk, Virginia. A one-fall battle with a 60-minute time limit. Wayne Hart, the referee, and we're nearing the 15-minute mark. And it has been your patented, genuine ring-a-ding-dong dandy right up to this point. Right now, Dynamite Kid appears to be in charge. He's inviting some of the crowd to come into the ring. Pretty cocky about things, isn't he? Terry Sawyer having some problems with that left leg. It has been pretty even Steven through the opening 15 minutes. Pretty even, but at this point in time, no questioning the fact that Dynamite Kid has the advantage. This is an on-title bout. The Dynamite Kid is the junior British Commonwealth Junior Heavyweight Champion. And of course, Vitaly wants a shot at the world champion, Nelson Royal. He'll be here in a couple of weeks. Whoops. Good shot to that left knee. Seemed to shake Dynamite up. Whoop. Look out. Gave him a knee on the inside of the leg. He's going after that left leg. A little bit of poetic justice for one Terry Sawyer. He wasn't paying attention to his knitting. Terry Sawyer, a man with a brilliant amateur background, the same is true out of Dynamite Kid. And that guarantees quite a match, always. Dynamite, as per usual, aided and abetted by John Foley at ringside. He has a frilly orange shirt on tonight. They call him Frilly Foley. Along with the Elton John dark glasses. Isn't he a sight for sore eyes? Me, he makes my eyes sore. But okay, meanwhile, back at the ranch. Dynamite chewing away on the ear a moment ago of Terry Sawyer and jams him on into that corner. Oh, he hit that turnbuckle. And again. What's this? Pulls him over. One, two, just two. That's all. Close. Oh, there's a solid shot to the midsection by Sawyer. Comes hammering back at him. Just a minute, Dynamite going up. It's a tap. Oh! There was a malfunction at the junction, and how sweet it is for those fans of Terry Sawyer. Sawyer has a look now, comes in with a solid elbow smash, works him off the ropes, sticks the abdominal stretch on him. He's pouring it to him. Has he got him? The referee asks. Whoops, he got just enough of that Sawyer brush cut to pull him down. Off those ropes he goes, over into it now. They both hit that deck. Both of them go down heavily. Seven, eight, they're all right, they're back in action. Gonna pull him over top, he does. Big suplex. Sawyer covers. One, two, and that's all. Into that corner. Whams him into that ring post, missed him. And we're at the 20-minute mark of this match. He turns him. Who's going down? rolls him. One, two, three. He got it. Barry Sawyer got it. Barry Sawyer got it. Dynamite is enraged by the loss. He is absolutely enraged, but Terry Sawyer has just beaten him. Terry Sawyer, you made a lot of people happy. A lot of people happy.
Well, I'll tell you, I said before that he was going to make a mistake. He's young and he's new in wrestling, and I've got a lot of experience, and he made that mistake, and I took advantage of it.
Well, it was non-title. That might be a frustration.
Well, as a matter of fact, here comes his little friend, John Foley, now. Foley, how about a title shot with your man here? How about a title shot for the British Commonwealth Junior title?
You want a what? Huh? Wait a minute, Sawyer! Sawyer!
I want a title match.
Sawyer! Listen here, Sawyer. You want a title match?
I want a title match.
Oh, the only way you pin me, you just pin me in the ring. You was holding my trunks. You was holding me trunks way on. You bully
mother. I didn't touch your trunks.
Just a minute,
Sawyer. You said you want a title shot. I've got news for you. You are not eligible. For a title shot, you are not a British subject. You do not belong to the Commonwealth country.
Right,
so
Sawyer.
There's no way as you,
are you
can get
are
a
you
title
afraid
shot.
Your man's going to get beat? Is that what it is, Foley?
No, it is
you're
my
afraid.
Boy what's going to wrestle Nelson Royal Stampede Week. I promise my boy this.
And the boy is going to be the next junior heavyweight champion of the world.
Here's
the Dynamite Kid, baby.
Here's the man that makes the match. He wants a British Commonwealth title shot. Foley says he's not eligible because he's not a British subject.
You might have a you might have
he's
an occasion
not
there.
A subject. He does not belong to a Commonwealth country, Mr. Hard. So there's no way as he can have a title shot.
We have the junior heavyweight champion of the world coming in here Stampede Week. And I was planning on the winner of this match going against...
He does not qualify.
Against Nelson Royal, the world champion.
You said the Commonwealth Junior Heavyweight Champion will go against Nelson Royal.
Well,
that's me, Stuart. That's me, Dynamite Kid. Not Terry Sawyer.
Dynamite Kid tonight. This man beat the Dynamite Kid tonight.
Just a minute. I may be in the main event here in a minute.
Hey, the chips are down. The chips are down.
The world title's got nothing to do with the British Commonwealth.
Right, what do you got to say about it? He beat the Dynamite Kid, and I'd say he's the man that's got the title shot right now.
Mr. Hart, you know the rules. He is not a British subject. He does not
that's
run to a Commonwealth
to
country.
World
well, I say it does.
It has nothing to do with
as
the world.
As far as I'm concerned, my boy gets the shot at Nelson Royal.
Nelson Royal is an American.
I would say the winner of this match gets the title with the shot with the Nelson Royal.
No one told me this, Mr.
Shot.
Hart. I have only just learned
what
this.
What are you going to rule, Stu? He'll yatter forever. What are you going to rule?
What have you got to say for yourself, Foley? This man was beaten fair and square in the middle of the
he'll
ring.
The front. He'll be doing the back.
Come on.
I would say the only thing to do is bring the match back then, and the winner, I don't say he will.
Do you want to agree to that?
He will win the...
Okay,
bring
he can't
win the. He can't win the Commonwealth belt. But if he beats your man, he will wrestle for the world title.
Okay, British rules, rounds.
Hey, I'll wrestle him any way you want to wrestle him because I've got something to prove that I've known for a long time, and that's that I can beat you.
You'll wrestle National Wrestling Alliance rules.
Okay, National Wrestling Alliance
he's
rules.
He's got a match.
Foley.
I'll
that's
agree.
It. That's it. And here it is, the main event. Jake Roberts, the Louisiana locomotive in there. 275-pounder against the 300-pound Big Daddy Ritter of Nashville, Tennessee. Non-title bout, but a very important scrap for both men. Because at the end of the rainbow, a shot with Harley Race, the world heavyweight champion. Ritter, the former North American title holder. Jake Roberts, the current king. And Jake won that crown from Ritter in this ring. Referee is Sandy Scott. It's one fall with a 1-hour time limit. And we've got about 11 minutes now. That's Rutter up top. Roberts down on the deck, but Roberts gets to his feet. I would say if you were scoring this fight on points up to the present, that Roberts would have enjoyed a wide lead. But just as we hit the television screen, Big Daddy Rutter began to come on. Tough night for John Foley thus far, with Dynamite Kid losing. And with the opening 10 minutes, he had to suffer through the fact that Rutter was outclassed by Roberts. But now, Rutter is coming back. Roberts dying to punch him out. There's the takedown. Rutter being warned about use of the hair, breaks the hold momentarily. One fall, 60 minutes. Roberts working his way up. Seventh bout on the card tonight. Showed you some of the action in five of them. Roberts, a little trouble with that hand, just a minute. Did Rutter load up that glove? The crowd over the other side, a little upset by something that Rutter has pulled here. He banged Roberts on the shoulder, goes after that shoulder, and the question is, did he load up the glove? Roberts is in difficulty. Pointing at that shoulder. Oh, Nelly. But Roberts has a problem with that shoulder. Can he hang on? Whoops, he went over the top instead of the shoulder block. There's a miss. Roberts starting to come on now. Got him coming in. But that shoulder is bothering him desperately. To the midsection, and another one.
Sleeper! Sleeper!
Got him coming in. Knocks him down. Cover one, two. Well, just about 1 3/4. Crowd yelling for the sleeper. There's a shot to the midsection. Rutter with that big bandage. Oh, he hurt his wrist. He hurt his wrist stopping that fist. Now he's taken something out of that bandage. And I don't know. He's got a chair. Grabs that chair, goes into the ring, bangs him on top of the head. They're going to have to wipe this whole thing out. Roberts wants a shot, knocks down the referee, and that's going to be that, and they wipe it out.
Hey, bring him back down here next week. He can have the title shot, and I'll give you my word. Either I'll leave Calgary, or I'll take that damn glove off of him and beat him half to death with it.
blade Jake
into our arms.
Jake Roberts says he's got a title shot.
That's what we want, a title shot. And then when we've got rid of Roberts, Daddy, you've got 2 weeks off to rest, and then you can fight for the world championship with Ollie.
Let me tell you something, Ed. I've been laying off for the last past 6 weeks, taking it easy with these boys, because my hand is injured. But you saw Jay Roberts, I had him beat. He nailed me in my ribs
with a chair.
But let me tell you something. Next week, Jake Roberts, I'm gonna put an end to the bones. It's two things in the world that the people don't mess with, Ed. The people shouldn't do. That's a dog chasing after a car, and these old broken down wrestlers chasing after Big Daddy. Not Jake Roberts. Next week, you're a witness, Ed. I'm gonna put the bones to rest. Me and the Knuckles, baby. You can put your dollar on that.
Okay,
and that will be the end of Roberts.
Hold on. And I know Stu Hart has something to do with it. He's always hanging around like old wounded dog.
Maybe okay, but in the meantime, in between time, that's it. Another edition of Stampede Wrestling. But by now.